Okay.
So, this should be reviewed for all of you guys. This should be reviewed for all of you guys. You did it in the summer homework. Okay? Remember your right triangle trig, soak and toe up. So, sine is opposite over adjacent, cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse.
I'm sorry, opposite over hypotenuse.
Tangent is opposite over adjacent. Yes?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay, now, the arc trig functions on your calculator. You hit second sine, you get arc sine, and that does the exact opposite. So you put in whatever your fraction is, and it'll give you what angle that is. And that'll be helpful for you later. Triangles to know. Do you guys know your standard triangles?
No.
Okay, 45.
30, 60, 90.
30, 60. 53, 37.
Oh, we didn't know that.
53, 37 is the 3-4-5 triangle. Okay. Those will come in handy. When you're doing just practice problems with a lot of math, 30s, 45s, keeps you easy, keeps going. Today we're doing 10, I think. Okay, now, why do we review the trig? Well, yesterday we talked about if you're moving in the x and you're moving in the y, you treat them separately. So what happens if I have a vector that's given to you in both the x and the y? So, for example, in our sample here, I have a 5 meters per second of my velocity at 37 degrees up. Okay, well that means it's going up some and it's going sideways some. But we don't know how much, because it says, you know, it's going 5 at this weird angle. Well, in order for us to treat them separately, we need to break it down into its components. Components. So what we're going to do is we're just going to treat it like a triangle, where I've got 5 is going to be my hypotenuse, my 37 is the angle, and then you do the trig to solve for your two sides. So if my overall speed is 5, that means my speed in the x has to be what? 4. And my speed in the y has to be?
3.
Look at that, you guys didn't even have to touch that. Okay, so you can plug those in now, 4 and 3, in your notes right now.
4 and 3?
Yeah. Okay. Because it's a 37 triangle, which we have. Okay. Now, how would that work if you were doing the trigonometry? What if it wasn't 37? What if it's 10? Well, sine is opposite over hypotenuse. I plug in my numbers. My opposite is going to be DOY. So I plug that in for opposite. My hypotenuse is going to be 5, so I plug that in for the hypotenuse. I rearrange it, so I multiply the 5 by both sides, and I get 5 sine of 37 will be DOY. Take out your calculator right now, type in 5 sine 37. Make sure your calculator is in degrees, please.
And 37
degrees. Yep. Okay, we got 3.009. Does that look a lot like 3?
Yes.
3.009 looks an awful lot like 3. Okay, now do the other one. Do 5 cosine 37, you should get 4.
5 cosine 37.
So, 4. We have 1 sig fig, so your answer is 1 sig fig. Okay.
5 sine
37.
Cosine.
Well, 5 sine will give you 1, 5 cosine will give you the other. Okay? Now, fun fact about triangles, if I do 5 sine of 37 or 5 cosine of 53, I'll get the same answer. Okay? So if you do this, the cosine of the complementary angle, it'll give you the same thing as if you had the sine of the original angle. Whatever. One minute. Okay, questions on this. Does everybody understand why we have to do it?
Yes.
Okay, so we're taking our vector and we're now breaking it into x and y so we can do what we did yesterday. Here is our sample problem.
It's Corolla cancer.
Literally,
Corolla.
This is like real news within the last week.
Oh,
this really happened.
A man driving his Corolla came to a canal at the end of
Not wanting to go around, he decided to jump.
Oh, that's badass. If he cleared it, at least. This is a deadly drop.
Did he clear it?
Yes. This man is the
greatest.
Well, let's put it this way. Number one, he made national news. So either it's amazing or really stupid, one of the two.
He probably missed.
All right, so.
Man, this is hard to order. Oh my god.
Kinematics is all about predicting motion, right? We have everything we need here. We can figure this out right now. So, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to set up my variables. X, Y. I've got X, X naught, E naught, X, VX, AX, D. Y,
D.
Y naught,
E.
V naught, Y, VY, AY, and T again. My box. Let's start filling stuff in. What do we got?
X is 7.
X is 7 meters?
Yeah.
We know he went 7 meters.
It didn't work. It says, oh my god.
We need to figure out how far he goes to figure out if he did make 7 meters. Yes, thank you, Wendy.
Mine spoiled it.
X not is 0.
X not is 0. Thank you.
Wait, why is it
0? Guys, have patience. We'll be done in 6 minutes and you'll know. Now what?
Why not at 0?
We're starting at 0, we're ending at 0. What else do we know?
Y is 10. Is acceleration? Maybe?
Acceleration where? This yet? 10 degrees, 10 meters per second. Okay, this is what we're doing. Kind of the point of today's lecture. So we have 10 degrees and he's going at 10 meters per second. Okay, so since this is a velocity, these two things will also be velocities and we need to figure out what they are. Okay, how do we do that? We have to do exactly what we just did. There.
Trigonometry.
Yeah. So what is this going to be?
VOX.
Yes, VOX. It would be VOY. Okay, what is VOX equal to? Is it going to be sine or cosine?
Cosine.
Why? Yes, we're looking for the adjacent side, so we're going to use cosine of 10. Okay? So, VOX is going to be 10 meters per second, hypotenuse, times the cosine of 10 degrees.